What's going on, everyone? It's Julian Cannon here of The Nocturnal. I am here at the Tribeca Film Festival to cover the Italian Studies red carpet. Now, it's the first red carpet I'm covering in about a year, so let's see what's going on. Here with Adam Leon to talk about Italian studies. How are you doing today?
I'm doing great.
I'm doing great as well. Now, I just heard you over there talking about Star Wars, and Star Wars is also one of my other favorite genres. Which is your favorite Star Wars film, and which is your least favorite?
Oh, damn. I don't know. Okay, so my favorite is Empire Strikes Back. I don't know. Do I have to do the least favorite? I'll say this. I'll say that the prequels have really grown on me. So, like, it took me a little bit of time, but I rewatched them recently, and I was always a little bit hesitant on them, especially the first two, and I sort of dimming them a lot. We used to, on set, we got into arguments about Solo, because one of our producers is a big fan of Solo, and so we would make fun of him, but, you know, it's all good. Movies are good. I'm not going to hate on anything.
No, hate on it at all. I thought some of them was good, some of them were okay, but we're here to talk about Italian studies today. What inspired you to take on this project?
It was actually Vanessa Kirby, who's the lead actress in it. She called me up. We were trying to make something together for a bit. We had been talking about that, and she was like, I'm going to be in New York later this summer. Let's try to figure it out. I called my producers up. I had an idea. I had some concepts that I was working with her on. I had done this live show with a bunch of teenagers from the city, and I was like, I think we could do something that puts that all together, and we did. So it was a rare project for me where it wasn't coming from my head to start with, it was fun. It was fun to do it that way.
I can tell that the way you describe it is very fun.
Great time. Yeah.
Now, were there any scenes that you had trouble filming with?
Any scenes that we had trouble with? Yeah, I mean, it's always tough. But the thing is that we really, it sounds sort of corny or like it's the right answer. But my dad once said to me right before I made my first movie, he said, like, don't freak out when something goes wrong. And I was like, everything's going to go wrong. And everything does go wrong in some ways. And you have to kind of embrace that and roll with that. And when you have a team like my team, when you have Vanessa Kirby, who is such a professional and also so patient and open and wants to try things, that good things can happen from that. And you sort of have to embrace that and you have to run to that.
Can you describe the casting process for me?
Yeah, some of them were, so Vanessa, I knew, and then it was non-professional actors from New York for the most part. Some of them I worked with on this live show, and then we had this incredible casting directing team, and they found a lot of teenagers in the city through Instagram, through street casting, and they would bring them in, and we would just meet with them. We wouldn't have them read. We would just hang out with them, talk to them, and we sort of put them together in different groups, see who kind of gelled, and took it from there.
You know, this film deals with someone that's lost in New York. Now, if this would have happened about 20, 30 years ago, no technology, how would you perceive this if this would have took place years ago?
Well, she loses her cell phone, so, you know, that sort of helps us narratively in some ways because she can't just call somebody and be like, but, I do think about, like, I'm of the age where I was a teenager in the city when, like, I had a beeper. You know, and so, like, but I didn't have a cell phone. So, I don't know. But she is so unmoored that it's like she's walking around 30, 40 years ago. She really doesn't have anything, and she doesn't know what to grab onto.
I'm looking forward to watching the film tonight. Thank you so much for taking your time to speak.
Peace and love. Thank you.